In order to make a sales transaction on your Android car terminal, tap on the hamburger menu on the top left-hand corner of your screen. Select Sale and enter the required amount. And press the green button. You can insert, tap, or swipe your card. And the transaction is being processed. For a successful transaction, the first receipt is for the merchant, and you have the option to print the second receipt for your customer. If we want to cancel this transaction, we go back to the main menu and select Cancel. Again, we insert, swipe, or tap our card, and the cancellation is being processed. We select the transaction that we want to cancel and select Yes. And the cancellation has been approved. We have the option to print the second receipt again for the customer.
References on your printed receipt can be useful in keeping track of what you're selling. In order to enable references, tap on the hamburger menu on the top left of your screen. Select System and Settings. From your Settings menu, you will see Payment Reference. Tap on it and toggle it on. You will see a menu where you can manually enter a reference by checking it, or you can scan a barcode. If you choose Scan, you must give permissions to your device to take and record videos. We will continue with the keyboard option. Move back to your main menu and type in the amount to be charged and select Enter. You will now get the option to enter the payment reference. Tap in the payment reference box and type the reference that you'd like to type. And tap on Continue. Proceed with the payment. And on the printed receipt, you will see the reference that you entered below the date and time of the transaction.
We provide some of our merchants the option to activate mail order telephone order payments on their Android card terminals after they have requested this in writing to support@vivawallet.com. These MOTO payments allow you to complete a sale when the cardholder cannot physically present the card. If your request has been approved, then you must go to your main menu, select System, and update your software. When the software update is complete, it takes you back to your main menu. Type in the amount that you want to charge and tap Enter. Select the MOTO icon on the bottom of the screen and enter the cardholder's card number. And the expiration date of the card. Tap Enter and Payment. Your receipt will show under the date and time of the transaction that this is a MOTO transaction. We provide some of our merchants the option to activate pre-authorization on their Android card terminals after they have requested this in writing to support@vivawallet.com. A pre-authorization is an amount held in the cardholder's account as a guarantee, usually for a service that will be provided at a future date. If your request for pre-authorizations has been approved, then you must go to your main menu, select System, and Update. After the update has been completed, then go back to your main menu and select Preauth. enter the amount to be reserved, and tap Enter. Tap your cardholder's card on top of the terminal. And you'll see a message that the transaction is successful. On the receipt, right above the amount, you'll see pre-auth printed. In order to capture or charge a pre-authorization, go to your main menu, select Capture Pre-auth, and tap the card that was originally used for the pre-authorization. Choose a transaction to capture. And from here, you can capture up to the full amount originally pre-authorized. Select Enter. From here, we confirm the transaction to be captured. Tap Yes. On the receipt, we will see the amount captured. Take note that a capture can be made up to 30 days after the pre-authorization was approved. A pre-authorization cancellation via your card terminal can be made on the same day that the original pre-authorization was approved. Go to your main menu and select Cancel Pre-auth. Tap the card that was used for the original pre-authorization. Choose a transaction and select Yes to confirm. On the receipt, you will see Cancel Pre-auth right above the amount that was canceled. Take note that if you need to cancel the pre-authorization after this date, you can do so through your Viva Wallet business account up to 30 days after the pre-authorization was approved. We give our merchants the option to activate the tipping option on their Android card terminals after they have requested this in writing to support@vivawallet.com. After the request has been approved, then you must go to your main menu, select System, and Update. After the update has been completed, then go back to your main menu and select System again, and Settings. Here you will see the tip option. Tap on it and toggle it on. From here you will see the option to activate tips based on transaction percentage and custom amount. The transaction percentage will give us three options that can be edited. And tap on Enter. We can also choose to turn on the custom amount option. Here the customer could enter a tip amount of their choice. Go back to your settings and to your main menu. Enter an amount to charge and tap Enter. You will immediately see that your customer has the option to give a tip based on percentage or a custom tip. Your customer could choose to enter the tip of their choice, and then you press Enter. Tap on Payment, and proceed with the charge. On the printed receipt, you will see the tip and the payment in full under Sale. Payment notifications allow you to complete a sale when the cardholder cannot physically present the card. You can simply enter the customer's contact details along with a note and the customer will receive an email with instructions on how to complete the sale. We can now send payment notifications from our Android card terminals. Tap on the card terminal app, enter the amount to be charged, tap on Enter, and tap on the payment notification icon on the bottom right of your screen. Fill in the customer's name, the customer's email, and you could type in a note to the customer. Tap enter and send. You will see that the notification was sent to your customer. You will be notified by email once a payment has been made.
Our merchants have the option to add specific information on their receipts printed from their Android card terminal. In order to choose the available settings, tap on the hamburger menu on the top left of your screen. Select System, Settings, Printing, and Business Description. Under the Business Description, you will see Business Name, Trade Name, and Store Name. You can choose one of these options to be printed on your receipt. In this case, business name is chosen. If we want to choose a trade name, we tap on it. And we see the check mark next to that option. Once you choose an option, you can select Print Test Receipt. And the option that you choose will show up just below Vivo Wallet's logo on the top of your receipt.